JT Daniels is going to the University of Georgia. Now, I saw the rumblings of this morning, and it was rumored. I didn't think it was going to happen right away, but everybody said, oh, it's trending this direction. Looks like he's leaning towards Georgia. And Georgia was never even an option. Like, until, what, a couple of days ago, really? Like, that's the first I'd ever even heard of this. And, like, I try and stay pretty connected in these college football things, man. I had never seen anybody even mention that Georgia was a possibility.
Just picked up the transfer quarterback from Wake Forest.
Yes, Jamie Newman. So,
like, a month ago.
If you get, and we're so late in the process now, obviously with the coronavirus stuff, like, if Jamie Newman, like, if JT Daniels gets eligible for this season, which it's possible he may not, and if he's not, then, I mean, that kind of helps things a little bit easier, like, makes things easier. But you've also got a five-star, like, the number two dual-threat quarterback in the country coming in next year, quarterback Brock Vandergriff. He's committed. Like, you got five stars everywhere. And, like, Jamie Newman wasn't a five-star, but he proved his worth at Wake Forest. If you are an elite quarterback, how do you trust that Kirby Smart has your best interest in mind? Like, how does he continue to do this? Like, it felt like they had their quarterback room set up. They were good to go. They had their guys lined up. And then you throw this kid in, and everything has gone to hell again. And I'm sure, like, I have no problem with competition, right? You want the best guy to win out. So you want as many cracks at the apple as you could possibly get. That's how it goes. But if you are a quarterback, I want to know what the hell these guys at Georgia are telling you that makes you think it is a good idea for you to go there. One, they haven't had success with one of them yet. Two, you just had two five-star quarterbacks transfer out so that the less talented one can play. Like, and don't get me wrong. I understand that Jake Fromm was the leader of that football team. I get it. But by God, Chris, help me out here.
No, yeah, you're exactly right. We found out that Fromm was third out of Eason and Fields. And Fields by a lot, by the way. And Fromm and Eason could be neck and neck, but Eason left for far less talent at Washington and still did just fine.
Yeah.
So, you know, I don't know the answer. I don't understand why quarterbacks continually go someplace where the position is filled. There's an understanding that, yes, you're a young buck and you want to, you know, compete for the best or whatever, but why on earth would you continue to go to the same schools over and over and over again? You see all these kids going to the same place at the same position. This isn't running back where they need four of them and two of you can be stars at one time. Like, that's just not how it works.
Yeah, not at the quarterback position.
Yeah, I just don't understand. And so now you've got two transfers that come into Georgia and a five-star freshman coming in. At some point in time, one of those guys, if not two of those guys, is going to transfer again.
Yeah, somebody, like, and don't get me wrong, the five-star kid that's coming in hadn't signed yet. So, yeah. Like, that'll be next year. And he could decide, well, if JT's there, why am I going to go here? Like,
it just cost you a signing? Yeah.
Right. No. That could totally be fine.
LSU was in consideration for JT at one point in time. There were rumors LSU was trying to get him.
Yeah.
And then those rumors just stopped. And I think at some point in time, this is one of the things I do appreciate about my school right now. I get that it's a cutthroat business and you want to win. And if the better guy you can get, go get him. But I think at some point in time, they said, we've made a commitment to Miles, and Miles knows the system. And I think we're just going to go forward with this. We don't know that the upgrade to get JT is that much better than Miles. And so we're just going to ride with the guy we already have.
Does Miles Brennan have 2 years left?
Yes. Or yeah. We have made a commitment to.
Yeah.
And I think there's something admirable to that of you've made a commitment to this kid made a commitment to you. You also have made a commitment to him.
Yes.
He played his role of sitting behind Joe Burrow and learning and being the backup.
And didn't transfer out.
That's right. Now it is his turn and you're giving him at least an opportunity. If it doesn't work out next year, then yeah, you go find somebody else, and that's okay. But I do think there's something to letting a kid have their shot if they waited all their time. I mean, if Ohio State had let Burrow have his shot and not brought in Fields, while Fields is pretty good, he would Burrow.
We got some guys in the chat right now. YouTube Swish Actions says, calm down, Gary. So I did get a little fired up there, didn't I? McKinnon said the Daniels decision is surprising but makes sense. If he wants to be taken seriously among the big boys of college ball in the NFL, being in the SEC is a fantastic way to do that, especially for Georgia, Florida, LSU, Bama, and Auburn. The Brown Yeti said, you look better if you win the job and a ring. Georgia hadn't won a ring in 40 years.
40 years.
Like, I understand that they've gotten close, but if that's what you're looking for, I mean, I'm just saying. And if you're the guy that gets them over the hump, yeah, you're going to be a legend forever, forever.
That's right.
But
if you're the guy that goes to Tennessee and turns that program around, now I know Tennessee is a good butt of the joke a lot of times, but if you're the guy that turns that program around, no. Don't think that, well, they had Peyton Manning, so nobody else can ever be a god. Peyton didn't win a championship, bro.
Nope.
He didn't. He came in and won it after that.
And Peyton's more beloved than T is.
That's right. Like, you will be more beloved than Peyton. I promise you. You just got to come in and change it up and win.
Bruce Morris putting in a bunch of smiley faces on YouTube or on Facebook here. I'm going to guess he's excited about the fact that I don't like this move. I think, like, it's not that I'm upset about this. Ben said, I hate Georgia. I just don't understand it from the kid's point of view.
That's it. Like, that's what doesn't make sense. When Fromm committed to Georgia, I just was like, they have Fields, they have Eason, they already have the last two number one quarterbacks in the country committed on campus. You're going to beat both those guys out? And he really didn't beat them out. He got the job because of injury or whatnot.
Yeah, so like it was Eason, and Eason had the job for a year.
Got hurt.
And then Fromm came in and got the job because of Eason getting hurt in the first game. And
that's
then Fromm led him to a national championship game appearance. And then you go from there, and then Justin Fields comes in because everybody kind of assumed, okay, now had he sat and waited and just redshirted his first year like it used to happen back 10 years ago or whatever, then that might have worked okay because Fromm was gone after this year.
That's right. Like,
I don't know. But this whole thing just doesn't make a ton of sense to me. I mean, cheers to the kid. Like, obviously, he thinks he's got the goods. You going to go in there and compete for that job and whatnot? Yeah.
Well, at first, he's got to get eligible. I mean, that's the thing.
But even still, he's going up against a five-star, number two dual-threat quarterback in the country the next season.
But I get that. But none of that's relevant if he didn't get eligible.
Well, no, he'll be eligible. It's just whether or not he'll have to sit out this season.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Hey, that's what I mean when I say eligible. What do you think I mean?
I thought you were just talking about eligible, period. No,
he can't play this year until the NCAA says it's okay. That's eligibility, right? You have to get somebody's permission?
Yeah, I thought you were talking about 2021. I'm sorry. I misunderstood.
What we're talking about here.
Ben said Georgia is a sorry football team and chokes every year. Doesn't matter how much talent they have.
No, because they got that dummy who's a hell of a recruiter as a head coach.
Look, I think Kirby Smart has done a fantastic job with that football team.
No, he hasn't. He's done a fantastic job recruiting.
And that's kind of where I'm at.
He's been outcoached in almost every game he has played in.
They
dominate teams because of talent.
He's got basically –
they are just better than them.
He's got basically the same record at this point in his career. As Mark Richt did.
Congratulations.
Matt Miller jumps in. JT Daniels is good, but why go to a place that has produced one good quarterback in the last 50 years to the NFL? Again, if you are a quarterback, why do you trust, like, I was going to say Mark Richt. I mean, I would rather trust Mark Richt than I would.
Oh, Mark, I'm going to tell you this. Mark Richt gives you your word. That man will lose standing by his word.
Yes. But Kirby, however, this is a different thing. Like, it is always, all right, we got this guy. Let's move on to the next one. Like, doesn't matter how it goes. Let's make it happen. So, yeah, it was surprising. It was, I just don't even know what to I don't know how to describe my thoughts on this. It made no sense to me for JT Daniels. Like, you had talked about Michigan. You had talked about LSU. You had talked about all these places that needed a quarterback. And now you're going to a place that kind of already had their quarterback room set, but you're going to try and fight for the job. Like,
Well, if that's the case, just stay at USC and fight for the job. You got a better chance of winning that job back.
And it's at home.
Then you do going somewhere else and stealing it away from another guy.
Sometimes I just don't get it. And this is like, we went that entire segment and didn't even discuss, some of the extra benefits that we always talk about. But, I'd love to see what was offered. Love to see that. Ben said
that could be it. I mean, the difference between Kirby's recruiting and Mark Richt's recruiting is the amount of money that they just had to influx Georgia with.
Yes. Yes. 100%. Ben said they won't win anything until Kirby leaves. That South Carolina game proved that he is not a good coach. There were a ton of games.
Listen, I stand behind that 1,000%. I think Kirby beats teams because that team is loaded with talent. But that guy is a moron.
I mean, he has proven it time and time again.
LSU game 2 years ago. 2 years ago, I watched them come into Baton Rouge, and they had two running backs. And one guy couldn't average 1 yard, and he touched the ball 36 times. And the other guy averaged it 8.5 yards a touch, and he touched it 8 times.
Yeah. Yeah.
And all I knew then was is every time Holyfield was on the bench, I felt great. And they go 3 and out, and then we beat their ass.
That's, 100%. I mean, the fake field goals, he jumps in on Swiss Action, says, wow, the hate. Yeah, we're kind of letting it fly today. It's not that I hate Kirby Smart. It's not that I hate Georgia.
I don't hate Georgia. Oof. I've never cared about it at all.
I don't hate Georgia. I'm not a Kirby Smart fan.
I surely do dislike Kirby. I just don't respect him as a coach. I don't think he's great.
It's mind-blowing, really.
Hell of a recruiter. Hell of a recruiter. And I don't understand that either because I've heard the man talk, okay?
Yeah.
You can make fun of Coach O's dialect, all right, from where he is from. That's fine. Yes, he sounds funny. But the things he says make sense. Kirby Smart is a dumb-ass country bumpkin.
The Brown Yeti said he's better than Moorhead.
100%. But that is trying to compare. I'm going to be nice about this.
Is this apples and oranges?
No.
Is that what this is?
No. No.
All right, we're going to leave it alone.
One guy's a dummy, and the other one is just completely out of his depth. That's just it. I don't know that Moorhead's an idiot. But Moorhead's just not close to the caliber of coach that you need to be in the SEC. Not close.
Or maybe not even coach, but, I mean, possibly leader. Like, maybe he doesn't need to be running a football program.
Any Power 5 school, he's just not.
He's not set up for it yet.
Wanting to do that. Or ever.
Well, I mean, obviously.
Those stripes don't change.
Maybe you're right. All right, let's dive into this next topic here.